Good evening, students. Welcome to ADA 24/7. The batch name is Ultimate Batch for IBPS RRB Pre-Exam 2019. And I'm your maths teacher. I am going to take the complete maths session for you. Please, everybody, join fast such that I am going to start from the basic onwards and nobody is going to miss this. Okay, friends, now let's start the topic. Let's start discussing about the session. As I told you, I'm your maths teacher and this batch name is Ultimate Batch. Why the name is Ultimate? Because the complete team for this batch is Ultimate and this is the best team they have been provided. So let us discuss about the exam first. I will brief you about the exam. In IBPS exam, IBPS RRB exam, there are two sections. There are two sections in this exam. One is mathematics and one is reasoning. There are 40 questions in maths and 40 marks. 40 questions in reasoning and number of marks, 40 marks. It means there are two sections. One is mathematics, other is reasoning. 40 questions each and total 80 marks. The complete time 45 minutes. So I would like to add one thing, that the time management is the main thing for this exam. Is exam ke liye time management bahut zyada zaruri hai. You will have to attempt maximum questions in less time. So my tricks will help you to attempt the maximum questions. I am going to give you the best tricks and best questions as well. These questions will be exam centric, the IBPS RRB PUN clerk exam. The square of a two digit number, it will help you in different questions. I am going to give you a best trick to find out the square of a two digit number. Let us take an example, 79. How to find out 79 square? आप सभी ध्यान से सुनिए. 79 का square find out करना है. 9 square is 81. 7 square is 49. The easiest trick I am giving you, you will be understand by two or three examples. I took an example for 79 square. 79 square is 9 square is 81. 7 square is 49. Now you need to multiply these three digits. 7, 9 and 2. 7, 9, 63. 63 twos are 126. Leave the first right side. Then put the number 126. I am going to repeat the same. Listen. 9 square is 81, then 7 square is 49, then 7 9s are 63, 2s are 126. Then you will have to leave this space, the first right side, the unit place of this. Add these two values, you will get the square of this number. 1, 8, 4, 16, 1, 9, 2, 11 and 1, 12, 4, 1, 5 and 1, 6. The square of 79 is 6241. Yes, 7 square, 57 square I need to find out. Take the unit digit, square of this number. 7 square is 49, 5 square is 25. The value I am getting, 7 square 49, 5 square 25. Then come to 5 sevens are 35, 35 twos are 70. You will have to leave this digit, then add 70 into this. You will get 3249. Is it clear? Take one more example. The value is 28 square. Listen carefully. 8 square is 64. 2 square is 4. But you will have to take two digits. As I took 8 square is 64, it is giving 2 digits, but 2 square is not giving 2 digits, it is giving 4. But you will have to make it 2 digits in every number. For every number you will have to take 2 digits for the first, 2 digits for the second. If it is giving, then it is good. If it is not, then add 0 before this. 8 square 64, 2 square 4. Then you will have to say 0, 4. Then come to 2 8s are 16. 16 2s are 32. Then leave this space and add 32 into this. Right side se aapko ek space chhodna hai and 32 ko aapko add kar dena hai. To value kitni aa gayi? 784. This is the value. Now let us take one more example. 86 square. 86 square, 3 digit number square is also possible. That is also possible. But aapke exam ke liye 2 digit square is enough. So 86 square is 6 square. Whenever I will get time, free time, then definitely I am going to add the cube root, the square root, the square also. 6 square is 36. 8 square is 64. 6 square 36, 8 square 64, 8 6 are 48, 48 2s are 96, add 96, leave this space and add 96, 6 a gaya, then 6 3 9, this 3, then 7, 73, 96. I have few examples, I have few questions for you. I took it from the previous year and few I made it for you. According to your syllabus and your exam point of view, I have made it. So let us start one of the example. 77% of 64. What will be the value? Agar mere ko 77% 64 ka nikalna hai, to kya answer hoga? Let us discuss 77% of 64. Aap isko kaise find out karenge? If I need to find out 50% of 64, then what will be the value? 50% of 64, 50% will be 32. Then 25% of 64 will be 16. It means I got 50% as 32. 64 ka 50% 32, 25% 16. Then how much percentage I got? 50% and 25%. It means I got 75%. Then I need to find out remaining 2% of 64. 2% of 64, it is 128 by 100. It means the value is 1.28. What I did, this is 50% of 64. This is 25% of 16. And this is remaining 2%. As the students used to say that 77 by 100 into 64. Do not multiply 77 and 64. It will give you the difficult way. It will be difficult to multiply. So what I did, 50%, then 25%. The value is simple, 32 and 16. The remaining 2% is 1.28. It means you got 49.28. The answer is 49.28. 77% आपको 64 का निकालना है, 50% कितना होगा 64 का 32, 25% कितना होगा 16 और 2% कितना 1.28. It means the complete value is 49.28. 2%, how to find out 2%? It is 2% of what? 2% means 2 by 100 of what? Of 64. This is 50% of 64. This is 25% of 64. Then I need to find out 2% of what? 64. So 50% of 64, 25% of 64. That is quite simple. 2% of 64, it is 2 by 100 into 64. It means 128 by 100. It is 1.28. The complete value, if you add, you will get 49.28. Let's move to the next question. You need to find out the largest and smallest number. I am giving you four options: 4 root 6, 3 root 7, 5 root 3, 6 root 4. 4 root 6, 3 root 7, 5 root 3, 6 root 4. Find the largest and find the smallest. Try. Everybody try to find out the value. Which one is largest, which one is smallest? Sabse choti value kya hai? Isko kaise discuss karna hai? Let us take one simple example. Let us take 7 and 12. Which number is small? 7 is small. Please listen carefully. This question is quite simple. I am giving you one more example. You will be able to relate this question easily. I am giving you two numbers, 7 and 12. The 7 is smaller, 12 is larger. If I will make square of 7, it will give 49. 12 square is 144. 7 is small, 7 square is also small. 12 is more, 12 square is more. If I will compare 7 and 12, 12 is more. And square of 12 is obviously greater. So, the number which is greater, definitely square of that number will also be greater. If you will listen carefully, definitely aapko ye samajh aayega and it will be easy. 4 root 6, make square of all of these. Square all. 4 root 6, square of this. 4, 4, 16, 6 96. Square of this. 4 square is 16. Root 6 is 6. Then 16, 6 96. Square of this. 3, 3 is 9. 9, 7 63. Square of 5 root 3. 5, 5, 25. Root 3, 3. 25, 3 75. 6 root 4. 6 root 4 is 6, 6, 36. Root 4 is 4. The value is 144. Which value is greater? Which value is largest? 144 is largest. It means 6 root 4 is largest. And the value 63 is minimum because 3 root 7 will be the minimum. Let us take one more example. You need to find out the largest and smallest. 2 to power 40, 3 to power 30, 5 to power 20. 7 root is not 7. I made the square of root 7. It will give you 7. Okay, let's discuss. 2 to power 30, 2 to power 40, 3 to power 30, and 5 to power 20. If I need to find out which one is smaller, which one is larger, then compare all the values. How to compare? Take the ratio. It will be simple. If you will try to calculate, there is a hype created by the students that in bank exams they used to ask the calculative questions. But if you know the trick, you know the method, it will be simple. 2 to power 40, 3 to power 30, 5 to power 20. If I will cancel out the zeros, 0, 0, 0, it is common to every number, every value. You will get 2 to power 4, 3 to power 3, 5 to power 2. You will get 16, 3 to power 3, 27, 5 to power 2 is 25. 25, 27 and 16. Which value is larger? 3 to power 3 is largest because 3 to power 30 is largest. And the smallest is 2 to power 40. This is largest and this is smallest. Is it clear to everyone? Aap isko ek tarike se aur bhi dekh sakte hain. इसको अगर आप रेशो में नहीं लिखना चाहते, if you don't want to mention this in ratio, then take 2 to power 40 is equal to 2 to power 4 to the complete power 10. 3 to power 30 is equal to 3 to power 3, the complete power is 10. 5 to power 20 is 5 to power 2, the complete power is 10. इसको मैं ऐसे लिख सकता हूँ, 2 to power 40 is 2 to power 4 and the complete power is 10. 3 to power 3 is ki power 10. 5 to power 2 is ki power 10. So the base is 2 to power 4. If I will solve, this is 16 to power 10. 3 to power 3, 27 to power 10. 5 to power 2 is 25 to the complete power is 10. So I can compare the base. The power is equal for all of these. It means 16, 27 and 25. I can compare 3 to power 30 is largest and 2 to power 40 is smallest. That's the other way to approach this. What if the power is not a multiple? Then dekho, in every question you cannot apply the same logic and same method, same trick. You cannot apply. You will get different questions, and when the values are different, when the question is different, you will have to try some other trick. By attending all of the sessions, you will be clear by this. Let us take an example of board mass. 48, divided by 6 of 2 multiply 2 plus 12 minus 6 divided by 2. Everybody try to find out 48 divided by 6 of 2 multiply 2 plus 12 minus 6 divided by 2. Now let us discuss this question, how to approach, because board marks is very important according to your point of exam point of view. So let's, everybody know about board marks, but they don't know how to apply. Board marks, B means bracket, O means of, D means division, M means multiply, A means addition, S is subtraction. प्यारे बच्चों आप इसको देखो, what I am saying, B means bracket, O of is multiply and M is also multiply. But if you will see of in your question, then you will try to solve of first, then division, then multiply. Of and multiply के बीच में division को solve करना होता है. Okay, let us start with bracket first. Do not touch the complete question together. Try to solve bracket first. 12 minus 6. Only 12 minus 6 will be solved first, because this is mentioned in the bracket. 12 minus 6 will give you 6 as the value. Bracket solved. Bracket solved. Now let us move to of. Iske andar of kahan hai? 6 of 2. You will get 12. Then come to division. Division. Now come to 48 divided by 12. And other term is 6 divided by 2. Dono ko solve karenge. 48 divided by 12 kitna ho jayega? 4 multiply 2 plus 6 divided by 2 will give you 3. It means 4 2's are 8. Now multiply. 4 2's are 8 plus 3. Now come to addition. 8 plus 3, 11 is the right answer. Let's have a fast look on this question. मैं इसको दोबारा explain करता हूँ, आप इसको तेजी से फिर देखिएगा, क्योंकि ये question ऐसा है जो आगे काफी questions को simple बनाएगा. 48 divided by 6 of 2 multiply 2 plus 12 minus 6 divided by 2. 48 divided by 6 of 2 multiply 2 plus 12 minus 6 divided by 2. Let's have a look on this question again. इसको दोबारा तेजी से solve करते हैं, fast solve करते हैं. इसको मैंने बताया आपको लगाना है board mass. B is bracket. सबसे पहले पूरे question में सिर्फ bracket solve करें. 12 minus 6, it will give you 6. Then come to of. Of is the main confusion. Of का मतलब multiply है. Multiply का मतलब आपका यहाँ M भी multiply है, but यहाँ आपको of को पहले solve करना है. 6 of 2 is how much? 12. 6 multiply 2. Now come to division. 48 divided by 12 will give you 4. Multiply को यहीं रखना है 2 में. 6 divided by 2 is 3. 4 2 is 8 plus 3 is 11 for this question. Is it clear to everyone? Okay, now please try one more question of board mass. This is simplification in board mass. Both 0.36 divided by 0.12 divided by 0.06. 0.36 divided by 0.12 divided by 0.06. Try to find out the answer. Now, let us come to the point. Whenever division is given, make it multiply and reverse the number, reverse the value. If I will say this is 36 by how much, remove the decimal first, 36 by 100, division is there. Isme kitna aega? 12 by 100. Isme kitna aega? 6 by 100. But I need to remove this division. If I will remove this division, it will change into multiply and will give you 100 by 12. Again, this, if you will change division to multiply, you will get 100 by 6. It means division will change into multiply, then you will have to reverse the number also. You will have to reciprocal the number also, the complete value. 100 cancel out, then 12 threes are 3 2s are 100 by 2 is how much? 50 is the answer. Is it clear to everyone? 50 will be the right answer. One more good question. This is of mixed fraction. 999 1 by 7. 999 2 by 7. It is going on 999 up to 6 by 7. These are 6 different terms. 999 1 by 7 plus 999 2 by 7 plus 999 3 by 7 plus 999 4 by 7 plus 999 5 by 7 plus 999 6 by 7. I am going to explain this. Aap sabhi dhyan se sune. 999 1 by 7 jo hai, ye value aap isko dhyan se dekho. Agar main isko solve karu ya na karu. अगर मैं इसको सॉल्व करूं या ना करूं, आप इसको समझ पा रहे हो कि ये किस तरह की वैल्यू है? 999 1 by 7 का मतलब है 999 के अंदर आपका 1 by 7 ऐड है. आप क्या करते हो, 999 को बाहर निकाल देते हो. 999 you are taking out and you are getting 1 by 7 plus 2 by 7 plus 6 by 7 and then you are getting 999 into 3. It will give you 1002. That is completely wrong. 2997, that is completely wrong. This is not the right answer. That's why I'll have to explain the fraction first. I'll take just 2 minutes to explain this. Let's understand the fraction first. There are two type of fraction. One is proper fraction. Just 2 minutes explanation is there. Proper fraction. Other is improper fraction. If it is given 2 by 3, it is proper fraction. If improper fraction, 3 by 2 is improper fraction. फ्रैक्शन का मतलब होता है द रिमेनिंग पार्ट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू इज डिवाइडेड फर्दर. इफ आई विल से, लिसन केयरफुली व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन, यू विल अंडरस्टैंड द कंप्लीट कंसेप्ट, देन द क्वेश्चंस विल बी सिंपल टू सॉल्व दिस. लेट्स टेक एन एग्जांपल. इफ आई नीड टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट 16 एप्पल्स इनटू 4 बॉयज, 16 apples into 4 boys, it means 4 apples per boy. If I need to distribute 17 apples into 4 boys, then you will get 4 apples per boy plus how many apple left? 1 apple. I will have to divide into the 4 boys. Remaining 1 is also divided in 4 boys. It means 4 apples each. And remaining 1 is divided in 4 boys. 4 is complete value. 1 by 4 is what? 1 by 4 is fraction. Bacha hua hissa, tukda, remaining part. This is 1 by 4. If I will say 17 by 3, you will get 3 fives are 15. You will get 2 by 3 also. It means 2 by 3 is what? This is fraction and this is proper fraction. 17 by 3 is also fraction, but this is not proper. This is improper. It means the proper improper can puzzle you. In brief, I will say one thing. If the numerator is smaller than denominator, then this is proper fraction. Fraction is what? Fraction is P by Q. If P is less than Q, then this is proper fraction. It means numerator must be less than denominator. Then this is proper fraction. If the fraction is not proper, it means P is greater than Q. It means P is greater than Q. If I need to divide 17 into 4, then I can say 17 by 5 kar lete hain. 17 by 5, 5 threes are 15. 3 2 by 5, 3 is complete and 2 by 5 is fractional part. 3 2 by 5 is not 3 multiply 2 by 5. This is 3 plus 2 by 5. If any mixed fraction is given, let's take. If any mixed fraction is given, let's take 7 1 by 3. What do you say? It means 7 1 by 3 means 7 3 21 plus 1. This multiply and this add. 7 3 21 plus 1 22 by 3. Or else I could say it is same as of 7 plus 1 by 3. 7 3 21 plus 1 22 by 3. It means 7 1 by 3 and 7 plus 1 by 3 both are same. And this is not 7 1 by 3. This is not. Now let's come to the question. It was 999 1 by 7 plus 999 2 by 7 plus up to 999 6 by 7. So if I will not solve this question, one thing I know, this value is approx to how much? This is 999, 1 by 7 means 999 se thoda sa zyada. It means 999 point something. I can take the round figure value as 1000. The next value also, 999 2 by 7 is same as of 1000. 999 6 by 7 is again same as of 1000. 999 से थोड़ा सा ज्यादा वैल्यू है, मैं इसको राउंड फिगर में ले सकता हूं 1000. तो हमारे पास कितनी वैल्यूज हो गई? द वैल्यूज आर 6. तो वैल्यू विल बी क्लोज टू 6000 इफ देयर विल बी फोर ऑप्शंस. 1002 2997 5997 6 216 and other option I can say 4997. Then I better know the value is very close to 6000. It means these two options are wrong. This option is also wrong. I can say out of these options, but this value I took 999 something as 1000. It means 1000 6000 is the maximum. The value will be little bit less of this, less than this. So 4216 cannot be the answer. So 5997 will be the answer. But one thing I would like to add, if you will get five options and five options are very close to 6000, then what will you do? You will have to solve the complete. Then I can take, if the complete is taken as 1000 1000 1000, then you will get 6000. If you will say I am going to take 999 999 999, then you subtracted 111 from each, then you're getting 5994. Agar aap isko 1000 1000 1000 mante hain to value will be 6000. Agar aap isko round figure mein kam ki taraf lete hain, 999 999 999, then you will get 5994. The value will be greater than 5994 and less than 6000. It means in between these two, answer will be there. Still, if you are saying the options are 5994, 5995, 5996, 5997, then what should be the answer? 999 1 by 7, I can write 999 plus 1 by 7. 999 2 by 7 means 999 plus 2 by 7. ऐसे ही अब अगर आप इसको लिखते जाएंगे, you will get 999 plus 6 by 7. How many values of 999 you are getting? You're getting 6 times as 999 plus 1 by 7 plus 2 by 7 plus 3 by 7 plus 4 by 7 plus 5 by 7 plus 6 by 7. After adding these values, 6, 5, 11, 11, 4, 15, 18, 20, 21, you're getting 6 into 999, 5994. And from this, you will get 21 by 7, you will get 3. Means the complete value is 5997. Is it clear to everyone? I'm taking a small example for the mixed fraction. If you're getting 2 5 by 7 plus 3 2 by 7, what will be the value? What will be the answer? 2 5 by 7 plus 3 2 by 7. This is for the beginners, those who are not able to understand, only 2 to 3 students only. So I have given you the the simplest way. Okay, how to do this? What will you do? This is 2 plus 5 by 7 and this is 3 plus 2 by 7. Because I told you before, 2 5 by 7 is 2 plus 5 by 7 and 3 2 by 7 is 3 plus 2 by 7. It means 2 plus 3 is how much? 2 plus 3 is how much? 5. Remaining is 5 by 7 plus 2 by 7. 5 by 7 and 2 by 7 is 7 by 7. You will get 1 from these fractions. 1 plus 5 is the complete value is 6. I think it is clear. आपको करना क्या है, पूरी पूरी वैल्यूज को पहले लेकर के जोड़ देना है. 2 plus 3 5, then add the fractions. 2 plus 2 by 7 5 by 7, this is 7 by 7, it means 1. It means you're getting 5 plus 1 6 as the answer. Yes, okay, I'm taking one more example. You please try to understand, almost every student understand. So you please focus. 7 1 by 2, 16 1 by 4 plus 13 3 by 4. What should be the answer? I'm giving the explanation. This is 13 3 by 4. I have no need to use sign now. 13 plus 16. This is 29. 29 plus 7. 36. 36 to hamare ko puri puri inse mil gaya. 13 plus 16 plus 7. 36 plus 3 by 4. 1 by 4. If you will add these fractions, you will get 4 by 4, means 1. Only 1 by 2 is left. The value is 37, 1 by 2. After solving the question, you will have to check the options, whether the option is giving 37.5 or 37, 1 by 2, in the form of mixed fraction or the decimal form. So whatever the form is given, you will have to check and take the option. Let's move to the first question of the PPT of the slide and try to solve. Then I will explain the better way to do this. 4.4 plus 14.44 plus 41.14 is equal to the question mark ki jagah par main isko x likh deta hoon. Minus 14.41 minus 1.4. Aap sabhi dekhiye isko approach karne ka tarika kya hoga. मैं इसको दो तीन अलग अलग ट्रिक से समझाता हूं. आई एम गिविंग यू टू टू देर आर टू टू थ्री डिफरेंट वेज टू अप्रोच दिस क्वेश्चन. वन वे द स्टूडेंट द फर्स्ट टाइम इफ द स्टूडेंट इज डूइंग इट, लेट मी एक्सप्लेन इट फर्स्ट. आई एम गिविंग यू ऑल द वेज, यू बेटर डिसाइड विच वन यू लाइक द मोस्ट. ओके, लिसन केयरफुली. द फर्स्ट टाइम इफ स्टूडेंट विल ट्राई टू अप्रोच, ही विल राइट like this. 4.4 14.4 14.44 41.14. if this value come on left side, you will get the positive 14.41. this value come on left side, you will get 1.4. if you will add the complete one by one, definitely you will get 75.79. I'm not saying that this is the method you are going to approach, you should apply it. No, I'm giving you one of the way student will try to find out. 4.4, 14.44, 41.14, 14.41, 1.4. if you will add all of these, you will get 75.79 by writing all of these values. One of the way. The other way, if I would like to add logic into this, then what can I do? I can multiply both sides by 100. What will you get? You will get 440. If I multiply 100 by this, you will get 440. If you multiply 100 on this, you will get 1444. Multiply 100 by this, you will get 4114. If you multiply 100 on this, you will get 100x on the right side. If you multiply 100 on this end, taken on the left side, you will get 1441. Multiply by 100 and taken the left side, you will get 140. Definitely you will get 75, 79. which is the value of 100x is equal to 7579. If you need to find out x, then you will get 75.79. Is it clear? There is no habit that students always try to note down it first, write down it first, then they used to add. You can approach both the methods, but I'm giving the third way, the best way to solve this question. What you are supposed to do, as you know, after decimal, there are either one digit or two digit. After decimal, there are either two digits or one digit. Then I can say, if I will add decimal ke baad, if I would like to add the unit digit, then I can say 4 plus 4, 8 plus 1, kitna? 9. Means I can say this is 9. Now come to the second digit. This is 4 plus 4, 8 plus 1, 9, 13, 4, 17. 79 aa gaya yahan se. One carry forward. 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 4, 6, 6, 1, 7, 7, 4, 11, 11, 4, 15. It means this digit is 5. Iske baad mujhe solve nahi karna. Don't solve further because after this, definitely I am going to get 7777. But the difference was of 4, 5, 6, 8, 3. It means mujhe itna hi solve karna hai. Is it clear to everyone? 5.79 will show you the difference that this is the right answer. No need to solve further. No need to write anything. Just take one by one. Is it clear to everyone? Okay, let's move to the next question. After decimal, either there is one digit or there are two digits after decimal. Check every value after decimal, either there are two digits or there is one digit. Add the first digit after decimal. Come to the values. I'm adding, you will have to look on this. Add 4. 4. There are two digits. I'm trying to find out this one first. 4 plus 4, 8 plus 1, 9. Is it clear? Now come to the second digit. I'm going to find out this one. This is decimal ke baad next. 4 plus 4, 8 plus 1, 9 plus 4, 13 plus 4, 17. It means this is 7. 1 is carry forward. Now 4 plus 1, it was left before. 4 plus 1, 5. 5 plus 4, 9. 9 plus 1, 10. 14, 1, 15. It means yahan pe kitna aayega? 5. 5.79 aa gaya, to aage solve kyu karna hai? Kyunki 5.79 sirf a ki option mein hai, jo ki b hai. Okay, let's move to the second question now. 2744 minus this is given. Okay bachcho, isme dhyan dijiye, isme you can solve by looking at last two digits only. Dekhiye isme agar hum last two digits se karke dekhte hain, iske last two digits kitna hai? 56. Last two digits 56, but this is with the positive sign, this is with the negative sign. Iske last two digits, iske last two digits will be cancel out. Now only three numbers left. Here it is 44, and here if this value will come on left side, you will get 986 with the negative sign. 14 18 18 of the negative sign, 86 of the negative sign, you will get 8 4 14, you will get 04. Take last two digits only, 18 and 86. Add these two, you will get 04. The plus value is with 44 and the minus value with 04. If you'll subtract, you will get 40 as the value. Is this clear to everyone? Have a look again. There are two positive numbers, 277, 1756, 2744 and 1756. The other values are 14, 18, 1956, and 986 come on the left side. You will get 986 with the negative sign. It means 1418 ये negative value है, 1956 negative value है, 986 negative value है. अगर आप इन सभी values को add कर लेंगे, you will get 4360. If you will add these positive values, you will get 4500. ये आपको positive value मिली 4500. इन सबसे आपको negative value मिली 4360. I can say 4500 minus 4360, you will get 140 as the answer. What I did, I added two positive numbers first, then negative numbers together. I am getting positive value 4500, negative as 4360. The difference of these two is 140. But what I did before, it was by using the last two digits. Last two digits of the positive value is 44. Last two digits of negative value 18. Last two digits of negative value, if come on this side, it is 86. If you will add last two digits of this, last two digits of this, you will get 04. 56 plus me, 56 minus, cancel out. 44 plus me, 04 minus me, you will get 40. It means last two digits will be 40. Those who understand the first one or second one, 104 hoga definitely, but I'll have to take last two digits only. Let's move to the next question. Okay, everybody try to solve this question. The fifth one, 7 1 by 9 plus 6 2 by 3 minus 4 1 by 2 is equal to x minus 5 2 by 9 plus 4 1 by 4 minus 4 3 by 4. So please have a look. What I am supposed to do first, take the complete values. 7 plus 6, how much? 7 plus 6, 13. 13 minus 4 is how much? 9. If this value come on left side, you will get plus 5. 7 plus 1 by 9 plus 6 plus 2 by 3 minus 4. This 4 1 by 2 with the negative sign, then this is minus of 4 plus 1 by 2. It means I will have to write 4 minus and minus 1 by 2 also is equal to x. But this will come on left side, you will get positive 5 plus 2 by 9. This value will be negative minus 4 minus 1 by 4. This value will be positive plus 4 plus 3 by 4. It means at the complete value 7 plus 6 13. 13 minus 4 is how much? 9. 9 plus 5 is how much? 14. 14 minus 4 is 10. 10 plus 4 is 14. Then come to fraction only. This fraction is 1 by 9 plus 2 by 3 minus 1 by 2 plus 2 by 9 minus 1 by 4 plus 3 by 4. This is 1 by 9 and 2 by 9. Then isko bhi agar main 9 banau, to 3 se multiply, 3 se divide karke, ye kitna ho jayega? 6 by 9. If I will add these three terms, then you will get 6 to 8 plus 1, 9. 9 by 9. After adding these three, I will get 1 as the value. Now, minus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4. Minus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4. You will get minus 3 by 4. Then this is 3 by 4. If I will add these two values, I will get minus 3 by 4 and this value is 3 by 4. Plus minus cancel out. And 14 plus 1 is how much? 15 is the value. Yes. Let's come to the sixth question. Take this value as x. Jo humare ko find out karna hai, take this as x. X multiply. If I will solve this, those who were not clear with mixed fraction, Please listen carefully. You will understand each and every step now. Have a look on this. I took X. What I need to find out about this value. This is 13 3 za 39 plus 1 40. 40 by 3 is equal to 6. 6 by 11 is how much? 11 6 za 66 plus 6 72 by 11. 7 2 by 9 is how much? 9 7 za 63 plus 2 65 by 9. 13 9 za 117 plus 4 121 by 13. मैंने मिक्स्ड फ्रैक्शन को इम्प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन में चेंज कर दिया है सॉल्व करके. ये 40 बाय 3, ये 72 बाय 11, 65 बाय 9, 121 बाय 13. नाउ कैंसिल आउट द वैल्यूज जो आपको दिखती हैं, उसको कैंसिल आउट करो. 11 का स्क्वायर है ये 11, 11, 121, इसलिए कैंसिल आउट. 13 5 जा 65, 9 8 za 72. Now x is equal to how much? X multiply 5, 8 multiply 5 multiply 11 इधर right side में बचा, इसमें कितना आएगा? 40 नीचे, ये वाला 40 by 3 इधर जाके क्या होगा? 40 नीचे and 3 ऊपर. 8 5 za 40 cancel out. X का value कितना होगा? 33. इसमें कोई doubt किसी को? Let's come to question number 9. This explain कर देता हूँ बिल्कुल basic से. देखिएगा इसको, हम इस term को पहले solve करेंगे, फिर इस term को solve करेंगे, फिर इस term को solve करेंगे, और तीनों को add कर देना है. 33 by 33 divided by 33. If I will divide, then it will cancel. 33 1. Then take 33 again, then it will give you 0. 33, 1 pay. You will get 101 from this. 4004 divided by 26 ko simple banane ke liye, take this as 2002 divided by 13. I can take it. 2002 divided by 13. 2002 divided by 13 will give you. This is 13 1 za, 13 5 za, 13 4 za. Then come to 650 divided by 25. 25 2 za, 25 6 za. So the values are simple. You just need to divide 33, 33 by 33. 4004 by 26. 450 by 25. If you will solve all of these, you will getting 1101, 154 and 26. After adding these three values, you will get 281. Question number 10. 15.5 hai. Aap isko likh sakte hai 155 by 10. I remove the decimal. This is 28 divided by 112 hai. Then I can take 28 divided by 112 plus 1230 by 240. 1230 by 240 hai ye. 28 by 112 hai. इसका डेसिमल हटाकर मैंने बाय 10 किया है. कैलकुलेशन कुछ ज्यादा नहीं है इसके अंदर कहीं भी. x इसको x मान करके बाय में 5 है, इसको कैंसिल आउट करिए. 28 4 जा, देन यहां से कैंसिल आउट करिए. 5 2 जा, 5 3 5 1, देन 0 0 कैंसिल आउट. 3 8 जा, 3 4 3 1. व्हाट यू आर गेटिंग नाउ? 31 बाय 8 प्लस 41 by 8 is equal to x by 5. If you will add these numbers, you are getting 72 by 8 is equal to x by 5. It means this is 8, 9, 72. It means x is equal to 9, 5 za 45. 15.5 ko aap kaise likh sakte hai? 155 by 10. Multiply is there, 28. Divided by 112, take this. Plus 1230 divided by 240, take by 240 is equal to x by 5. जो दिया है मैंने उसको वैसे का वैसे लिख दिया. अब इसको कैंसिल आउट करना है, फिर ऐड करके बस वैल्यू सामने आ जाती है. कैंसिल आउट द वैल्यू बाय 5. 5 3 जा, 5 1 जा, 5 2 जा, 28 4 जा, 3 8 जा, 3 41. यू आर गेटिंग 31 बाय 8 प्लस 41 बाय 8 इज इक्वल टू x बाय 5. यू आर गेटिंग 72 बाय 8. इट मींस 8 9 जा, x by 5 is equal to 9. It means x is equal to 9 5 za 45. Is it clear now? Now after this you will get few questions in which you need to find out the square root of few numbers. Let's take an example. If I need to find out the square root of 6241, how to find out? I'm giving you a trick. If you need to find out the square root, as I gave you the trick for square, now I'm giving you the trick for square root also. The value is 6241 ka root find out karna hai. I'll have to understand that last two digits, the unit digit is 1. Take last two digits together, take first two digits together. Last two digits ka unit digit pe focus karna hai. 1 kaise aayega? Kisi bhi value ko multiply karna hai. If two numbers are multiply, number ending with 9 or number ending with 1, 9 9 multiply ho karke 1 dega, either 1 1 multiply ho karke 1 dega. So as we know, 1 square is 1, 9 square is 9981. So any number ending with 1, if multiply 2 times, will give you unit digit as 1. Any number ending with 9, if you will make square of this, then definitely you will get 1 as the unit digit. So definitely whatever the value for this square root, definitely I am going to get 9 in the end or 1 in the end. This 62, this is 7 square is 49 and 8 square is 64. We know this. 7 square is 49 and 8 square is 64. This value is in between 7 and 8 ka square. You will have to move on the smaller one. It means you will have to take 79 or 71. It means iska square root ya to 71 hoga ya 79 hoga. But which one? Because this value is nearby to 62, is nearby to 8 square. It means this value cannot be 71. This is very close to 80 square. So 79 will be the answer. It will not be clear by just one example. You will have to learn 4-5 examples, then it will be clear to you. Let's take one more example. Before this, I need to understand, if I'm taking a number, let's take 31 multiply 31. Then if I'll multiply whatever the value I'll get, but the unit digit will be 1 for this. 32 multiply 32. 2 multiply, you will get 4 as the unit digit. I'm talking about unit digit. 33 multiply, you will get unit digit as 9. 34 unit digit will be 6. 35 unit digit will be 5. 36 unit digit will be 6. Same as 37 multiply, you will get 9. 38 multiply, you will get 4. 39 multiply, you will get 1. Right? Now I need to understand, if number ending with 5, if multiply 2 times, then definitely unit digit is 5. Number ending with 6, definitely unit digit is 6. Number ending with 1, definitely unit digit is 1. But number ending with 2, you will get 4 as the unit digit. Number ending with 3, unit digit will be 9. Number ending with 4, you will get unit digit is 6. 7, then you will get 9. 8, then 4. 9, then you will get 1. I just want to explain about unit digit. If you will focus on unit digit, then it will be easy to find out the square root. 7921. If I need to find out the square root of this. 7921. Iska square root find out karna hai. Let's have a look. This value is more than 80 square, isn't it? I am giving you one more easy way to do this. This value is more than 80 square because 80 square is 6400 and 90 square is 8100. 80 square is, as we know, 80 square is 6400, 90 square is 8100. This value 7291, it lies between 80 and 90. So I can say, if I am not able to say which number is this, but at least I can say the square root of this lies between 80 and 90. But looking at the last digit, I can say either this is 81 into 81 or this is 89 into 89. 89 into 9, because last digit in dono se hi 1 milega aur iska last digit 1 hai. And this value is very much close to 7921, is very much close to 90. It means the value cannot be 81. 90 ke close kaun sa number hai? 89. So this is square of 89. Is it clear now? 1 minus 2 plus 3 minus 4 plus 5 minus 6 up to 97 minus 98. Try to solve this. 1 minus 2 plus 3 minus 4 plus 5 minus 6 up to 97 minus 98. 1 minus 2 plus 3 minus 4 plus 5 minus 6 up to 97 minus 98. Okay, sirf 1 minute, 15 second dhyan do, iska answer aapke samne hai. Total terms kitni hai? How many terms are there? Total 98 terms. 1 plus 1 minus, 1 plus 1 minus. There are total 98 terms. 50% are of positive, 50% are negative. Okay. How to solve this? If I take first two terms, 1 minus 2, how much you will get? Minus 1. 3 minus 4, if you will solve, how much you will get? Minus 1. 5 minus 6, how much you will get? Minus 1. It means two terms together, you're getting minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. And last two terms together, minus 1. How many times you will get minus 1? 49 times. 49 with the negative sign. This is the answer. Aap in dono ko solve karo. Agar question itna hi hota, 1 minus 2, to kitna value aata? Minus 1. Aur agar 3 minus 4 hota, to kitna aata yahan se? Minus 1. Yahan se kitna aata? Minus 1. यहां से ऐसे ऐसे चलता रहेगा तो लास्ट तक कितना कितना आता रहेगा माइनस वन माइनस वन माइनस वन माइनस वन और ये कितनी बार आएगा दो टर्म से एक मिल रहा है दो टर्म से एक मिल रहा है दो टर्म से एक मिल रहा है टोटल 98 टर्म्स थी तो कितना मिला होगा 49 विद द नेगेटिव साइन लेट्स मूव टू द अदर क्वेश्चन हमारा माइंड हमेशा कैलकुलेशन की तरफ जाता है उससे बाहर निकालना है root of 12, root of 12, root of 12, root of 12, up to infinity. Okay, let me explain this. If whenever you are getting root of x, root of x, root of x, root of x, up to infinity, then without thinking anything, just say x is the answer. There is no sign, no positive, no negative, nothing. Root of x, root of x, root of x, root of x, up to infinity. the value you will get x. Same as I gave you an example, root 12, root 12, root 12, up to infinity. Without thinking anything, you can give me the answer. 12 is the answer. Is it clear? Any value. Root of 7, root of 7, root of 7, up to infinity. What should be the value? For every question, I have the explanation. Without logic, without base, there is not even a single question. So let us discuss. Root of 12, root of 12, root of 12, up to infinity. Let's understand the meaning of infinity. If I will say one person have money, so if we are not able to count the money, so I will say that person is having that much money that we are not able to count. The stars in the sky, akash mein jo tare hain, the stars in the sky, infinity to count because it is uncountable. Root 12, root 12, root 12, it is going up to infinity. It means there are so many terms, never ending. I can keep the complete is equal to x. The basic I am giving you for this question. कहां से इसका आंसर 12 आएगा, कैसे इसको सॉल्व करना है. टेक द कंप्लीट इज इक्वल टू एक्स. इफ आई विल इग्नोर जस्ट वन फर्स्ट टर्म, द कंप्लीट वट एवर आई रिप्रेजेंटेड इन द सर्कल, वट एवर आई रिप्रेजेंटेड इन द सर्कल, इफ आई विल इग्नोर जस्ट वन टर्म, द कंप्लीट ऑल्सो कैन बी टेकन एज एक्स, बिकॉज रूट 12, रूट 12, रूट 12, रूट 12 इंफिनिटी तक जा रहा है. It is going up to infinity. The complete whatever I took in the circle can also be said that it is equal to x. So I can say this is equal to root of 12x is equal to x. Square on both sides. This is 12x is equal to x square. So x, x cancel out and x will be equal to 12 for this. This is the logic behind it. You will get this method in 9th class book also. NCERT, 9th class book. Definitely in your academics. So is this clear? Root 17, root 17, root 17, root 17 up to infinity. 17 is the answer. It will take just 1 second. You got the answer. 17 is the answer. Is it clear? Root 5, root 5. Root 5, root 5, what should be the answer? Now have a look on this question. Root 5, root 5, root 5, root 5, this is not up to infinity. This is not up to infinity. Bhai, this is up to just 4 limited terms. So for this question, first I need to check whether the terms are going up to infinity. If going up to infinity, what should be the answer? Directly you could say 5 is the answer if going up to infinity. But if infinity is not mentioned, if infinity is not mentioned, root 5, root 5, root 5, root 5, the explanation, the logic behind this, if I will take this is equal to x, the logic and the explanation behind this I'm giving you fastly. Take the complete is equal to x. Square on both sides, one root will be cancelled, again square, second root will be cancelled out, again a square, third root will be cancelled out, again a square, fourth root will be cancelled out. But it will be hell for you to make 4 times square of this. So you need the shortcut for the same. Explanation behind this, square 4 times on both sides, again and again, again and again, again and again, 4 times you will have to make. Then it will be difficult to find out the shortcut for the same. As if I might, if the value was going up to infinity, then it was 5. But for this question, again, you will have to take 5 outside. Then take 2 to power n minus 1 by 2 to power n. N is what? N is number of times the root is given. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then I could say 5 to the power 2 to the power 4 minus 1 upon 2 to the power 4. Then 5 to power how much? 2 to power 4 is 16 minus 1, 15. By 2 to the power 4 is how much? 16. Understand the concept? This is the short trick for this very good question. Root of 11. This is finite series, not infinite. If infinite, then answer could be, answer is 11. If it is finite, what I am supposed to do? 11 in the base, then 2 to power n minus 1 upon 2 to power n. N is what? N is number of time root is taken. 2 to 3 students were asking, what is n, sir? N is number of times the root is taken. 1 root, 2 root, 3 root. It means n ka value kitna hoga? N is 3. So 11 ki power 2 ki power 3 minus 1 upon 2 ki power 3. This is how much? 2 ki power 3 is 8 minus 1, 7 by 8. 11 ki power 7 by 8. This is the right answer. Root 17. What should be the answer? 17 in the base, 2 to power 4 minus 1 upon 2 to power 4. 17 to power 15 by 16. It is the right answer. I think it is clear to everyone. The last question it was, if we are getting the value like this, that root 20 plus root 20 plus root 20 up to infinity. For this question, what should be the answer? Root 20 plus root 20 plus root 20 up to infinity. What should be the answer? As I explain that root 20 up to infinity. Isko dhyan se sune sabhi. Confusion dur hoga. There is little bit difference of these two questions. If root 20 up to infinity, then the answer is 20. If root 20 plus root 20 plus root 20 plus root 20 up to infinity, then the answer is not 20. Here 20 is not the answer. Isme mere ko kya karna hai? I will have to break the number in two parts. Into numbers. In fact, into two consecutive numbers. Definitely the number is going to break into two consecutive numbers. 24 multiply 5. I can break 20 as 2 into 10, 1 into 20, so and so. But I will have to break 20 into two consecutive numbers, 4 and 5. As if positive is given, 5 is the answer. Now, if root 20 minus root 20 minus root 20 up to infinity is given, if this is given, then what should be the answer? Then again you will have to break the number 4 into 5, two consecutive numbers. In case of negative value, negative sign, you will have to answer, then the answer is 4. If positive, then 5 is the answer. Is it clear? There is a bit difference. If root 20 up to infinity is given, then 20 is the answer. Okay, let's take more example for this question. Root 56 up to infinity. There is a positive sign in this. What I am supposed to do, I'll have to break this number into two consecutive numbers. It is 56 is can be written as 7 into 8. Can be written as 2 into 28, can be written as 2 into 4 into 14, but we are supposed to take two consecutive numbers. 56 is break into 7 into 8. 8, the larger number, is the answer. That's it. If plus and minus both given, plus is given, is this clear? If plus is given, then I'll have to break this number into 2, 7 into 8. 8 is the answer, the larger one. Is it clear? If root 61 minus root 56 root 56 minus root 56 minus root 56 up to infinity. Then break this number into 7 into 8. The smaller will be the answer. If one of the student asks, if it is not possible to break the number into two consecutives, let's take root 5 plus root 5 plus root 5 up to infinity. What do you say? Iske liye aap trick likh lijiye. If this number we are not able to break into two consecutive, then what should be the value? Iska jo value hoga, this is 4x plus 1 root plus 1 by 2. For this question, you can find out the value by using this. Put 5 into this. I was not supposed to give you this question because this question, they can rarely ask you this question in banking exams. They used to ask this question in SSC exam. When the number we cannot break this number into two consecutive. So if you are asking, then I need to explain. Then put x is what? X is 5. 4 into 5 plus 1 plus 1 upon 2. How much is the value? Root 21 plus 1 upon 2. Is this clear? I am giving you more examples. Dekhiye. सारे क्वेश्चन हम एक साथ में इसके सेम तरह दिखने वाले सारे एक साथ करके देख सकते हैं. root of 23 up to infinity. If this is given, root 23 up to infinity, the value is 23. If root 23 if this is not going up to infinity but up to three terms, then what we are supposed to do? 23 as the base, 2 to power 1, 2, 3, 2 to power 3 minus 1 upon 2 to power 3. Then 23 to the power 8 minus 1, 7 by 8. 23 to the power 7 by 8, and this is 23. Abhi tak maine jo discuss kiya hai ye dono. Now, finite or infinite? With no sign, not positive, not negative. If the value is root 42 plus root 42 plus root 42 up to infinity, then what will you will get? This is 6 into 7. Then 7 is the answer because plus is given, the bigger one. Isko do numbers mein break karna hai, two consecutive numbers, take the larger one if plus sign is given. Root 42 minus root 42 minus root 42 up to infinity. Have to break this number into two consecutive. Minus sign is given. The smaller one, 6, is the answer. Is this clear? Now, if the fifth condition, if you are not able to factorize, if you are not able to break this number into two consecutives, then what to do? This is root 7 plus root 7 plus root 7 up to infinity. What to do in this case? I am giving you a shortcut. 4x plus 1 in the root plus 1 upon 2. Put x as 7 because 7 is given. Put x as 7 into this. You will get the right answer. 4 7s are 28 plus 1. Root 29 plus 1 by 2. This is the answer. If in case this plus sign is not given, if root 7 minus root 7 minus root 7 minus root 7 is given, up to infinity is given. If this is given, root 7 minus root 7 minus root 7 minus root 7 up to infinity, then what we are supposed to do? I need to find out root of 4x plus 1 minus 1 upon complete by 2. यहाँ आपको plus रखना है अगर यहाँ plus चल रहा हो. यहाँ अगर minus चल रहा हो तो यहाँ आपको minus रखना है. If plus, then plus. If minus, then minus. In this case, if minus is given, value kya aegi? Minus, minus, minus. So yahan minus lekar ke, put x is equal to 4. X is equal to 7. 4 7s are 28 plus 1 29. Root 29 minus 1 complete by 2. This is the answer. Root of 6 plus root of 6 plus root of 6 up to infinity. What should be the answer? Root 6 plus root 6 plus root 6 up to infinity. What should be the right answer for this? 3 is the answer. But I would like to say, if I will use the formula 4x plus 1 root plus 1 upon 2. Put x is equal to 6 into this. This is possible for every value. Whether 6 is given or 7 is given or 8 is given, 12 is given, whatever. So put x is equal to 6. Put x is equal to 6. 4, 6 are 24 plus 1 root 25 plus 1 upon 2. Yahan se kitna aega? 5. 5 plus 1, 6. 6 by 2 kitna? 3 is the answer. This is the other way. This is the lengthy way to find out. So we are not supposed to use this method for the numbers which can be factorized into two consecutive numbers. So 6 can be factorized into 2 into 3. So 3 is the larger number I am supposed to take. So don't use this trick for the numbers which can be factorized into two consecutive numbers, but can be applied for those numbers which cannot be factorized. Whether it is root 7, if I will take, okay, one example if I'll give you, then you will better understand. You can use this trick for any, let's take root of 10, root of 10, root of 10, up to infinity. This is not the prime number. Pyare bachcho, isme aapko prime number nahi dekhna. Any number, root 10. Is it possible to factorize root? Is this possible to factorize this number 10 into two consecutive numbers? No, this is not. It can be factorized in 1 into 10 or 2 into 5. So, for this, I'll have to use the same trick. 4x plus 1 plus 1 upon 2. Batai answer kitna aa raha hai? 4, 10, 40 plus 1 root 41 plus 1 upon 2. Root 41 plus 1 complete by 2. Negative ka formulae mein itna hi difference hai, root of 4x plus 1, root of 4x plus 1 minus 1 complete by 2. This is for the negative, aur agar wo positive hai, to beche plus aa jayega. Negative tha, minus aa jayega. That's it. Let's move to other questions. Let's come to the next question. आप बताइए, एक बहुत अच्छा क्वेश्चन आपके लिए लेकर के आया हूं मैं. रूट ऑफ 5 प्लस रूट ऑफ 11 प्लस रूट ऑफ 19. तेजी से इसको लिखिए सभी. प्लीज नोट डाउन दिस क्वेश्चन फास्टली एंड ट्राई टू गिव मी द आंसर. रूट ऑफ 5 प्लस रूट ऑफ 11 प्लस रूट ऑफ 19 प्लस रूट ऑफ 29 प्लस रूट ऑफ 49. द कंप्लीट रूट इज देयर. ध्यान से देखिएगा सभी. If you will look at this, then you will understand. Else you will be confused. Those who are not able to find out, those who made the mistake by on finding the answer, have a look on this. Root 49 will give you 7 as the value. 29 plus 7 is 36. Root of 20 plus root of 29 minus root of 12 plus root of 19 minus root of 9. Root 9 is what? Root 9 will give you 3. 19 minus 3 will give you, root 9 is 3. Root 19 minus 3 is 16. 19 minus 3 is 16 will give you 4. 12 plus 4 will give you 16. Root se bahar kitna aayega? 4. 25 minus 4 will give you 25, will give you 5. 5 plus 20 is 25, will give you out as 5. Is it clear to everyone? One more question of same kind. Root of 74 plus root of 700 multiply root of 42 plus root of 42 plus root of 42 up to infinity. Solve this question. root of 74 plus root of 700 multiply root of 42 plus root of 42 plus up to infinity. चलिए इसको एक्सप्लेन कर देता हूं मैं. लेट्स डिस्कस. एज वी नो प्रायोरिटी इज टू सॉल्व दिस वन फर्स्ट. इट इज गोइंग अप टू इन्फिनिटी. वी नो वी नीड टू फैक्टराइज दिस 42 एज 6 इंटू 7. सो द लार्जर नंबर इज द वैल्यू फॉर द कंप्लीट. सो आई विल गेट 7 फ्रॉम दिस कंप्लीट रूट ऑफ 74 प्लस रूट ऑफ 700 multiply 7. From this you will get 74 to already hai plus mein 700 into 7 hai to yahan se kitna bahar aayega 7 into 0 matlab 70. You will get 144. Will you get 12 as the answer. Let's come to the next concept, next question. Everybody try to find out root of 9 plus 2 root 14. Root of 9 plus 2 root 14. Options. Root of 2 plus root of 7. Root of 3 plus root of 9, root of 7. 13. Or none of these. Options like this. I need to find out the root of 9 plus 2 root 14. What should be the answer for this? A plus B whole square will be used. It will give you A square plus B square plus 2AB. You will have to remember the reverse as well. A plus B square is A square plus B square plus 2AB. Or a square plus b square plus 2ab is equal to a plus b ka whole square. Right? So this concept we are going to use into this, because if I need to find out the square root of any value, then it must be square of anything. You cannot find out. Okay. Okay. Take simple example. Root of 36 is how much? Tell me. Root of 36 is 6. We know this. Root of 36 is 6. Root of 37 is how much? It will not give you the exact value. You will have to check the table. You will get the value in decimals. Root of that value is possible. Jiska square banega. Jo kisi value ka square hoga. Wahi to square root se bahar aayega. It means, whatever the value is there inside, you will have to make this value as perfect square first. So, let's come to the question again. As I told you, that it will work upon a plus b whole square. So, root of 9 plus 2 root 14. I will have to break this, the last term, as 2 multiply root 7 root 2. Why I break this? Because this 9, this last term always will give you 2ab. This last will give you always as 2ab. And the first term will give you a square plus b square. So, I'm not teaching you the algebra, but it is the question they can ask in your exam, and you will have to find out the answer quickly. Definitely you will find out the answer in 5 seconds. 5 seconds. That's my challenge after understanding the concept. So if this value is equal to 2ab, so this is 2 root 7 root 2. This is a, this is b, because root 7 ka square is 7, root 2 ka square is 2. So root 7 is 7, root 2 is 2, 7 plus 2, 9. It means this is root 7 square plus root 2 square. The complete is root 7 plus root 2, the complete whole square. Then with the root, you will get root 7 plus root 2. I am taking one more example. The question is, let's take one more example. 7 plus 4 root 3. 3, the complete root of this. As I know, what is this? This is 2ab. This is 2ab. 2 into 2 into root 3. This b, this a. I'll have to check for this. 2 square plus root 3 square. This is a, this is b. A square is 4. This square is 3. 4 plus 3 is 7. It means a square plus b square plus 2ab. The complete is there. This square is 4, this square is 3, means together it is 7. And this complete will multiply, will give you 4 root 3. Because humne wahi se nikala hi hai. The value we will get 2 root 3. 2 plus root 3 is the answer for this. Ek example aur, last example, last question. Main aap se discuss kar raha hu. Aap sabhi isko achhe se samajna. The last example I am giving you. Try to understand. Try to understand with your best of understanding. 15 plus 2 root 56. It will take just 5 to 10 seconds to understand. As we know, what is this? This is 2ab. And what is this? What is this? This is a square plus b square. This is for sure. This is a square plus b square. And what about this value? This value is 2ab. Break this number. Break this value as 2 root 8 root 7. Root 8 ka square karenge to 8 aa jayega. Root 7 ka square karenge to 7 aa jayega. 8 plus 7 is 15. So the complete is root 8 plus root 7. The square with the root, you will get root 8 plus root 7. If this question is not clear to you, definitely I am going to take more examples in the next class. So do not worry, isse pehle aapko sab kuch samajh aaya hoga, sab kuch clear ho gaya hoga. So try all these questions, whatever we discussed today. Negative is involved, then I can say if there is negative sign, then a square plus b square minus 2ab will be there. Then it will be a minus b ka whole square, then root. Then you will get a minus b. Then the answer will be root 8 minus root 7. Okay? Then the answer will be root 8 minus root 7 if negative sign is there. So, mere pyare bachcho, aaj ke liye itna bahut hai. Thanks, thanks all of you. I hope you understand whatever I explained today. If you don't understand, then still try to understand again and again. Still any doubt, you can ask in the next class. Thanks all of you for today. And we will continue the next session in the next class. Thanks for today.